Hello, fourth grade students from all over Costa Rica. Welcome to Learning at Home. It's me, Teacher Graven. And how do you feel? You feel awesome. Good. And what day is today? Today is Friday. What day was yesterday? Thursday. And what day will be tomorrow? Saturday. Good. Are you ready to explore, learn, and have lots of fun? Well, this is the right place to be. But before continuing, we were supposed to have a new classmate today. It's right here. Hello, little buddy.
Hello, how are you?
Very good. What's your name?
My name is Osvaldo. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Osvaldo, how do you feel?
I feel great.
Did you wash your hands already?
Yes, even though I have no hands, I washed them.
Okay, did you wash your hands at home? Michael, Patricia, Mario, Flora, did you wash your hands? No? Okay, don't worry. I'm going to give you 20 seconds, so please go and wash your hands. Meanwhile, today we're going to listen to some songs and we are going to watch some videos from YouTube in order to learn English. And those videos are used only for educational purposes, okay? Ready? So let's start. Today we're gonna have some greetings from classmates and we're gonna have a Christmas English festival. What? What are you saying, Osvaldo?
We have a message from a friend.
Oh, really? So we are going to listen to Maria Angel Mata Ramirez. She has something to say to you. Let's pay attention. Hello, Maria Angel.
Good morning, Teacher Vivian Slanis. How are you? My name is Maria Angel Mata Ramirez. I speak English thanks to all of you at Learning at Home. Happy holidays! Bye, see you!
Thank you so much, Maria Angel, and thank your family as well. You did a wonderful job.
Okay, remember that we want to invite the whole family to please come here and join us.
That's very important. And we are having a video from UNICEF. And Paola is going to mention something about natural disasters. So pay attention to Paola. Hello, Paola!
Today, we will talk about natural disasters. Do you know what a natural disaster is? Well, a natural disaster are the violent events that are outside of the human's control. They are caused by the powers of nature, for example, floods, hurricanes, tornadoes, volcanic eruptions, earthquakes, tsunamis, storms, and others. A country's location has an important influence on the possibility of natural disasters. Also, since Earth, it's kind of like a puzzle, countries located on top of where the pieces connect have bigger chances of suffering from an earthquake. In Costa Rica, we have high chances of natural disasters. Our country is located on top of two puzzle pieces called tectonic plates. They are called Cocos and Caribe. This is the reason why it's always shaking in our country. Also, earthquakes can cause another type of common natural disaster in our country, like landslides or the sliding of soil downwards. Now, make sure to follow the instructions and what to do in case of a natural disaster. Please share this information with your family. See you soon. Bye, guys.
Goodbye, see you. And thank you once again, UNICEF and Paola. Great video. Now, Osvaldo, do you remember the natural disasters that Paola mentioned?
Well, she said something about earthquake, floods, hurricanes, tornadoes.
Yes, and that information was very important.
I would like to review about natural disasters.
Okay, so let's review. Do you want to play a game? Yes.
Yes, I like games.
So let's play a game about natural disasters. Okay, here we go. This game is called Hidden Natural Disasters. Okay, and we're gonna we need to find the image. Okay, so what about if we press those colors? Osvaldo, you're doing it very fast. Wow, you're really fast.
Let me see. I'm gonna take this one away. I'm gonna touch this color. This one. I know this natural disaster. Okay. Let me see. Okay, I want this one away and the purple ones. Oh, that's easy. That's an earthquake. That's an earthquake. Very good. That's an earthquake.
Okay, and you mentioned that's an earthquake. Now, how do you feel when there is an earthquake?
I feel really sad.
Okay, and what do you do in case of an earthquake?
Well, you scream.
No, of course not. You have to stay
calm.
That is right. And we have to cover our hands, correct. And what else?
We have to be very calm and get under a table.
Okay, get under a table. Really good. Now let's continue with the next one, okay? Let's continue with the next one. Remember, Osvaldo, to press the colors. You have to touch the colors and the picture is going to appear. Rectangle by rectangle, you have to put them away or take them away, okay? Now let's see the next natural disaster.
This one was pretty easy.
Yeah, it was really easy for you.
Okay, I'm gonna press this color, these yellow colors, and then maybe the purple ones. Okay, let me see. I'm gonna touch the green colors. And then, let me see. I want the red ones. Okay. Oh, I know this natural disaster. It's pretty easy. It's pretty easy. It's a flood.
Okay, really good, Osvaldo. That is a flood. And how do you feel when there is a flood?
Well, I feel sad.
And what do you do in case of a flood?
Okay, maybe I can call 911 to ask for help.
Yes, really good, really impressive. So, it was pretty easy for you, Osvaldo.
Yes, it was pretty easy.
Okay, great student. Now,
teacher, what are we going to learn today?
Let's see what we are going to learn today. Let's see our lesson goals for today. And today we are going to review what we have learned. We are going to talk about a familiar topic in a short presentation. We are going to describe common diseases, symptoms, and treatments. And don't forget our riddle for today, our self-regulation riddle. Remember to ask your English teachers for help, your family and your friends. Let's see. It is green and big. It's full of lights for your own delight. It brings you joy in times like these. But be careful and remember to unplug it before going to bed. What is it? Oh, Osvaldo, do you know the answer yet?
I'm going to say the answer at the end of the class.
Good. Now, what?
You were saying something about an English festival, right?
Yeah, but not only an English festival, but a Christmas English festival.
That is so cool.
Yes, it's so cool. Do you love Christmas?
Do you love Christmas? Yes, I do.
Good. Now, what about if we start our Christmas English festival with spelling bee?
Yes, that's very cool.
So let's meet the students who are participating. Okay, first, we're going to have Nathan Aguirre Valverde. Now, Nathan, I have a question for you. How do you spell the word emergency? Hello, Nathan.
Hello, my name is Nathan.
How do you spell emergency?
Emergency. E-M-E-R-G-N-T-Y. Emergency. Thank you, Aprendo en Casa. Merry Christmas. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much, Nathan. Wonderful job. And thank your family and your teacher as well. Now, we have another student.
Is it Diana?
No, it's not Diana.
So where is he or she?
It's right here.
Who, me?
Yes, you, Osvaldo. You are the next student who is participating.
And what do I have to spell?
You have to spell, Osvaldo, the word flood.
Flood! Jesus Christ!
Okay, don't worry, I'm going to help you.
Flood. F. L. O. O. O.
Osvaldo, only two O's.
But you mentioned four O's.
No, only two.
D. Flood. F-L-O-O-D. Flood.
Good job. Okay. Now, who is the winner of this spelling bee contest? Let's see. Oh, that's really good. And the winner is... both of you, Nathan and Osvaldo.
Am I the winner with Nathan?
Yes, you are the winners. Good job, Nathan and Osvaldo. Now, we're having the impromptu speech contest. And let's meet the students who are participating. Okay, first we got Casey Cotto Chavez. Casey, I have two questions for you. Let me see. What did you learn at Learning at Home? And what do you do in case of an earthquake? Hello, Casey.
Hello, teacher Gravy classmates. How are you? I am Casey Valeria Cotto Chavez. I learned some simple structures in English in case of an earthquake, like covering my head. Thank you, Learning at Home. So long.
Earthquake. What did I do in the earthquake? First, I covered my head. Second, I got under a table. Then, after the earthquake, I made a line and didn't stand near the window. Finally, I was calm.
Thanks once again, Casey, and thank your family on my behalf. You did a wonderful job. And we have another student.
Really? Is it Diana?
No, Osvaldo, it's not Diana. Sorry, Diana.
Osvaldo, who? Where is he or she?
Once again, it's right here. Remember, you are a student.
Really?
Yes, and I have two questions for you. What did you learn at Learning at Home? And what can you do, Osvaldo, in case of an emergency?
Well, I learned that I have to call 911 in case of an emergency.
Ah, you have to call 911. And what about if we have a conversation in order to practice that call?
Really?
Yes, really.
Okay, let's give it a try.
Okay, let's see. I'm the operator and you are the kid calling.
911, what is your emergency? Please help me. There is a flood near my house.
Okay, and what is your name?
My name is Osvaldo.
And Osvaldo, where do you live?
I live in Heredia.
Really? Okay. Is your mother or your father there?
Yes, my whole family is here.
Okay, be calm. First, calm down. The firefighters are coming to help you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, now, who is the winner in this contest? Let's see. I think both of you are the winners once again. Casey and Osvaldo, congratulations. Great job. What about a round of applause? Very good. Now, we have a student who is participating in the impromptu conversation contest.
Really, Teacher Graven?
Yes, really. We have Eduardo Sanchez Brenes. Eduardo, I have this situation for you. First, what did you learn at Learning at Home? And I want you to talk about with a partner about health and a visit to the doctor. So, hello, Eduardo.
Hi, Teacher Raven and classmates. How are you? I am Eduardo Sanchez Brenes. Hello, what is your name? How are you? Hi, my name is Jesus Sanchez Brenes. I am wonderful, thanks. Let's have a conversation. Perfect! Did you like the program Learning at Home? Of course I did. I learned a lot. I learned how to speak English. What did you learn? I learned how to have a conversation at the doctor's office. Thank you so much, teachers. See you. Thank you, teachers. So long.
Jesus Sanchez Brenes. Let's role play. Ready, Jesus? Here we go. I'm ready. Hello, sir. I'm Dr. Eduardo. What is your name?
Hi, doctor. My name is Jesus Sanchez Brenes.
What is the matter with you?
I am sick. I feel terrible.
What are the symptoms?
I have high fever and body pain.
How many days have you been with these symptoms?
3 days, doctor, 3 days.
Have you taken any medicine?
No, sir, what can I do?
Well, you have dengue fever. I recommend you should take this medicine.
Wow, amazing. Eduardo, thank you and your family. Wonderful job. Okay. Osvaldo, who is the winner in the impromptu conversation contest? Oh, okay, yeah. And the winner is Eduardo, congratulations. Wonderful job, wow. Isn't it great, Osvaldo?
What?
Wow, we have great students here in Costa Rica.
Like me?
Yes, like you and like all of you at home. You really know how to speak English here in Costa Rica. Wow, great job. Now, Osvaldo, do you like games?
Yes, I love games.
And do you like Christmas games?
Yes, I do.
So what about if we play this game? Let's see. Here we go. Now, you have to press these colors in order to guess the picture or the image. Wow, you're doing it too fast, Osvaldo.
I'm gonna press these colors. I'm gonna press this one, put this away, take this one away.
Wow, you're doing it fast. Osvaldo, calm down.
Oh, that's easy, that's an angel.
Good job, Osvaldo, that's an angel. Now let's see the other one. Okay. Slower, Osvaldo. Don't go too fast.
I'm taking away these colors. Okay, let me see. I'm taking away this one. Okay, I'm almost done. About to finish. And this one, I'm gonna press this one, that one. This one right here, this one. Okay, I think that's a bell.
Correct, Osvaldo. That's a bell. Good job! Wow, you're a really fast student!
Thank you!
Wow, now do you like to sing?
Yes, I do.
And do you like to sing a Christmas carol?
A Christmas carol! Wow, that would be so awesome!
So, what about you at home? Do you like to sing? Good. So, let's have this song and let's try to read the lyrics, okay? It's called Jingle Bells. So, here we go. Let's try to sing at home. Sorry, I like to dance and sing Christmas carols. It's one of my favorites. Did you like the song?
Yes, I did. It was wonderful.
Okay, now I'm wondering how many stars you got today? Let's see. Okay, let's have our self-evaluation. So we talked about a familiar topic in a short presentation. We described some diseases, symptoms, and treatments. And you got two presents. Wow, amazing, Osvaldo. We got two presents. Good. Now, do you remember our riddle at the beginning of the class? Let's see. Let's remember it. It is green and big. It's full of light for your own delight. It brings you joy in times like these. But we have to be careful and remember to unplug it before going to bed.
It's a Christmas tree.
Oh, amazing, Osvaldo. Now, something very important that we need to take into account. Personally, I would like to thank a lot of people for all their help. Okay, first, I would like to thank God for this opportunity and my family too. I would like to thank MEP, Repretel, Grupo Garnier, Ana Campos, Ofelia Montoya, Marianela Marin, and I would like to also thank some teachers that helped us, Arlene Madrid, Roxana Vargas, Ever Cordero, and Clarita Ramirez. Of course, all the students who participated in our classes and their families. The production team, Jose Escalante, Maria Brenes, and Elmer Chavarria. The sign language interpreters, Adrian Rios, David Montealegre, Diana Zúñiga, the designers, Daniela Peláez and Carlos Soto, and of course the drivers from MEP, Dagoberto Cibaja, Eric Oviedo, and Mauricio Valerio. Thanks to all of them, okay? Now, I would like to personally call some of those people. Well, first, thank you, Diana, for your help. And I would like to call Ana Campos. Please come here. Thank you very much, Ana, for the opportunity. Okay, and also we would like to ask Ofelia. Okay, so thank you very much once again for the opportunity, Ofelia. Thank you very much. Jose, please come here. Thank you for your hard work. We really appreciate it. Thank you. We would like to thank also Maria. She was a great helper in this program. Thank you, Maria. Thank you. And we would like to say thank you to Elmer for all your great help. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you, Elmer. So, it was a pleasure for me being at Learning at Home. We really appreciate all your help, all the students watching at home, the families. Thank you for the opportunity of having me right here. And it was my pleasure. Remember to wash your hands, wear a face mask, okay? And help your family, protect your family. I hope you learned a lot English with teacher Marianela and with myself. And thank also the Spanish teachers from Learning at Home, the social studies teachers, the mathematics teachers, and the science teachers. They did a wonderful job. And of course, also the national advisors who helped us. They did a wonderful job. We really appreciate it. And I just have to say thank you, you at home, for watching us. It was my pleasure. So, see you next time. Bye-bye. Take care. See you.